This is the holy war that sane people have feared and zealots have prayed for. They want you to pick a side and kill each other. But we can always choose peace. The word Israel was first presented in the Bible as a name given to Jacob after he fought an angel. Its meaning was a man who has struggled with God and is commonly translated as God prevails or man seeing God. Many have argued that the word Israel in the Bible does not refer to a place, but rather a believer or a group of believers in God. Others believe the land known as Palestine was where the biblical state of Israel once stood. And in the 17th century, Sabbatai Zevi was the first Jew to try and resettle there. Sabbatai Zevi claimed to be the Messiah and amassed a large Jewish following that engaged in ritual and the defilement of God's law. In the spring of 1666, they were planning to be the first Jewish settlement in Palestine. But things changed when Sabbatai was arrested and thrown in jail. His radical movement continued with the Frankism movement, and Zionism became more political. Although they claimed to be secular, the Zionists flooded the temples with prayers for a return to Zion and a restoration of the Jewish state. But the rabbis rejected them. In 1885, the rabbis wrote that we consider ourselves no longer a nation, but a religious community, and we therefore expect neither a return to Palestine nor a sacrificial worship under the sons of Aaron, nor the restoration of any of the laws. While the rabbis offered no support, the Zionists garnered the support of the British crown as early as 1841, and they were funded by the Rothschild banking dynasty, otherwise known as the Bank of England, so the crown was likely involved from the start. In 1897, the political intent to recreate the State of Israel was made official to the public, and in 1917, under the British government's Balfour Declaration, British troops seized control of Palestine on behalf of the Zionists. In 1922, the League of Nations adopted the declaration. And in 1947, the United Nations granted parts of Palestine to the Zionists. Between 1947 and 1949, Palestinians were made refugees and kicked out of the homes of their ancestors. Hundreds of villages were destroyed, and thousands of Palestinians were murdered in a series of massacres known as the Nakba. The Zionists killed Palestinian Muslims, Christians, and Jews. The Zionists claimed to be non-religious, but they were mostly Ashkenazi Jews. The Ashkenazi can be traced back to the Khazars, the progenitors of Rabbinic Judaism. The Khazar Khaganate was a major empire in what is now Ukraine, Georgia, Armenia, Azerbaijan, and parts of Russia, Turkey, and Iran. It was ruled by the Khazars, but made up of several diverse nomadic tribes. In the year 740, the Khazars mass converted to Judaism. Synagogues and schools were built, and Rabbinic Judaism was born. The original Jerusalem Talmud was replaced by the recently codified Babylonian Talmud, which was based on Babylonian philosophy and became the mainstream, thanks to the Khazars and the Zionists. Some Christians believe that this is the synagogue of Satan written about in the Bible, which say they are Jews and are not. And many other Christians have become Zionists themselves. The Zionists have tremendous support from American megachurches and Christian evangelicals, many of whom believe that as the world becomes a fiery hell, they will be saved and brought to an eternal paradise. But in order for this to happen, the Temple of Solomon must be rebuilt, and two-thirds of the Jewish people must perish. According to the Bible, King Solomon's temple was constructed in 957 BC and destroyed in 586 BC, rebuilt again in 516 BC, and destroyed again in the year 70 AD. Many Christians and Jews believe that this temple must be rebuilt in order for their Messiah to come. But there is something in its way. Originally built near the end of the 7th century, the Al-Aqsa Mosque is considered one of the three holiest sites in Islam. Islam teaches that this is where the Prophet Muhammad ascended to heaven. The Temple Mount has been occupied by Israel ever since the Six-Day War of 1967, and now it looks like they are ready to complete their mission. This is the holy war that sane people have feared and zealots have prayed for. They want you to pick a side and kill each other. But we can always choose peace and learn to love our neighbors. The origin of Friday the 13th has its roots in the ongoing Holy War. Specifically, Friday the 13th in October, which is noteworthy seeing as how a worldwide Islamic jihad has been called for on Friday the 13th in October. The Knights Templar gained wealth and power by fighting as mercenaries for the Catholic Church during the Crusades. Their headquarters was in the Al-Aqsa Mosque on the Temple Mount in Jerusalem, on Mount Moriah, where Abraham built an altar to sacrifice his son. King Solomon's Temple is a central component of all three Abrahamic religions, and especially in Western occultism. The Templars were officially known as the Poor Fellow Soldiers of Christ and of the Temple of Solomon, or Templar Knights. Masonic lodges are based on the Temple of Solomon. Kabbalah teaches that the Temple of Solomon represents the metaphysical world and the descending light of the Creator through the Tree of Life. The Templar Knights wore white mantles with a red cross, a symbology that can be found throughout the history of the Catholic Church and its offshoots. The rebuilding of King Solomon's Temple is a crucial goal of many religious groups and secret societies. The Templars were not only expert warriors, they were also pioneers in an early form of banking, and arguably one of the world's first multinational corporations. They acquired land throughout Europe and the Middle East, including the island of Cyprus. They owned and operated several farms and vineyards. They built massive stone cathedrals, and they had their own fleet of ships for war and for the import-export business. When Jerusalem was recaptured by Muslim forces in 1187, the Templars were forced to leave the Al-Aqsa Mosque on the Temple Mount, but they still managed many businesses and wielded much power. King Philip IV was deeply in debt to the Templars and began pressuring the church to take action against them. At dawn on Friday the 13th of October 1307, mass arrests were carried out against the Templars. Claims were made that the Templar recruits were forced to spit on the cross and deny Christ. They were accused of worshiping Baphomet and a mummified head believed to be that of John the Baptist. Dozens of Templars were burned at the stake, and the order was officially dissolved. The Temple Mount remained under control of Muslim forces until the British captured it in the Battle of 1917. 30 years later, the United Nations gave the land surrounding the Temple Mount to the Zionists, and the State of Israel has been encroaching upon it ever since.